get started, we're going to pick up where we left off with the previous class, not the ninja class, but the one before that, where we were doing the kicks. So that was the 3 o'clock class. We're going to pick up at the green belt level and hopefully get all the way through the red belt and Chodambo level. Okay, all of the kicks under black belt. Alright, here we go. Come up, samida. Alright, starting off, we're going to talk about inside-outside crescent kick. Okay, so first, my body turns. My knee comes up even with my opposite shoulder. My kick will peak in the center and come back. So it makes this little half moon or crescent shape like this, with the kick peaking directly in the center. So from my fighting stance, my knee comes in, comes across, and then down. So without extending the leg, I turn, my knee comes in, across, and back. That's for the inside-outside crescent kick. So my left foot will go this way, and my right foot will go this way, like McDonald's arches. Something coming from inside the box, outside the box. Here we go. Inside, outside crescents. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Switch. Same thing, other side. One. Two. Three. Four. Okay, I'm hitting on inside-outside crescent, the outside edge of my foot, all right, the sharp edge of my heel coming across, outside edge. That's inside-outside crescent kick. Now, when I do outside-inside crescent, that would be like I'm taking something outside the box or the pot and putting it in, outside in, like I'm clapping my hands together this way. Okay, so I'm hitting with the inside edge or inside arch of my heel this way. So my knee comes out here, across and in. I end like a side kick chamber. So again, what my knee does, a lot of times you'll see this hitting the hand this way, okay? For right now, we're doing it striking, not hitting our hand. So outside in, up and over. Again, outside in, up and over, okay? And I almost forgot. There we go. I'll show inside outsides again real fast so that if there was anything that we missed. Inside outside. One, two, three, four, five. Inside outs again since we have the other camera view. Two, three, four, five. Now outside ends. Other foot, outside, inside. Okay, so those are both inside, outside, and outside, inside crescent kicks. Okay? A few of the other kicks that we don't do a whole lot as green belts, mostly because they are simple type of kicks. Some wouldn't really classify these as kicks, but they're kicks nonetheless. So, what is called stomp kick. Stomp kick, when I do the stomp kick, it wouldn't simply be like picking my foot up and stamping my feet like somebody doing a temper tantrum, but more like picking my knee up, similar to a side kick, and then driving my heel and the outside edge of my foot into the target. Okay? So, in Korean, this is chippa-gibup, or a stomping technique. So, my knee comes up like a side kick, stomping down with the heel. Alright? Other side, stomping kick. Okay, stomping kick. All right, the next one we're going to talk about is pop-up front kick. So when I do a pop-up front kick, is a back leg jumping front kick. When people are learning their jumping front kick, a lot of times they'll do it this way incorrectly. So, as we covered before, a regular jumping front kick, my back leg comes up, my front leg throws the kick in that 1-2 action. Same thing with the jumping roundhouse kick, my back leg comes up, my other leg comes around and throws the roundhouse kick. Pop-up kicks are different. Pop-up kicks, I'm in my fighting stance, I bend my knees, I jump straight up in the air as the other foot, as the back leg throws the kick. It's very common to see this one practiced with both feet jumping together at the same time. Both with the pop-up front kick and the pop-up roundhouse kick. A lot of times, you'll see people from this position, they go from here, and then they jump up and throw their kick. That is a sport karate version of this kick, and that is not the proper way to do this kick. The proper way to do this kick is right from the fighting stance. So all I'm going to do, without throwing the kick, all I'm going to do is I'm going to bend my knees, spring up, and throw my hip forward as if I'm throwing the kick. Okay? Again. And this is both the front kick and the roundhouse kick. So, I bend my knees, I spring straight up, and I throw my hip forward, okay? Now with the chamber of the front kick, I bend my knees, I spring up, and I pick my knee up. Both of my knees come up, as well as, I don't know if you saw, my non-kicking leg. So my non-kicking leg will also come up at the same time. Again. Okay? That is the jump for both kicks, both the pop-up front kick and the pop-up roundhouse kick. It's a back leg jumping kick. So, this time, pop-up front kick, I bend my knees, I'm going to spring up in the air, this foot is going to kick, landing in front, and my stance is going to change. So when I do this, most of the time when we practice this, we practice it alternating. So, pop up front kick, I spring up, one, kick, the other leg's in front, two, three, four, five, six. Give that a try. Pop up front kick. Alternating legs each time. Let's see if anybody has any questions. No? No questions? Okay. Moving on. Same idea for the pop-up roundhouse kick. Same kind of jump, except now My back leg is throwing a roundhouse. I bend the knees, spring up, and I turn my body roundhouse kick. Done the same way. There isn't really a pop-up sidekick. A pop-up sidekick would mostly be like an in-place flying sidekick without running. We typically don't do that one. It's not really a kick. It can be. Alright, good. So, we covered inside-outside crescent, outside-inside crescent, stomp kick, pop-up front kick, and pop-up roundhouse kick. The next major one that green belt levels have to know is jumping spinning back kick. So, when I do a jump spinning back kick, if I'm facing you, my kick, when the kick completes, I should be looking over my shoulder. Same as, like we talked about, for the regular spinning back kick. Okay? A jump spinning back kick is similar. Also, when I throw a jump spinning back kick, if I'm fully committing to throwing this kick, I would actually end up taking up real estate. I would end up being closer to you, because I want to throw my body weight into the kick. So, throwing one at the camera, jumping towards you. One more time. All right. So, on the bag, you can see both in the view down the bottom and then this view here, my distance should be about the same as I would for the regular spinning back kick. Okay? Let's make sure we have enough space here. All right. So, I want to be, when I throw this kick, this way. I don't want any part of my chest like sideways like this, or even facing the bag. That makes it more like a overturned kick or like a front kick. So, jump spinning back kick. I set my stance. See how my chest is this way. So that's the idea behind jump spinning back kick. When I throw the kick, this way. If you start to see the front of my chest on this kick, I turn too much. All right, thumbs up if we're good. Unless you guys have questions about that kick in particular before we move on. Sure, our view is good. Thumbs ups. Good. Okay, here we go. More about spinning kicks. Earlier we talked about wheel kick, how wheel kick, the leg stays straight, cuts all the way through the target, ends up back where it started. Spinning hook kick is similar, except when I throw my spinning hook kick, I turn, I push my hips towards the target, and I actually chamber the same way like I would for a side kick or a hook kick. So as I throw my spinning hook kick, I turn, I push my hips, I chamber up, snap the kick, it hooks, and I come all the way around. Spinning hook kick always comes all the way around. Where people get in trouble is they leave the foot in front and they're not really coming all the way around. You could do that, for example, in sparring, if you don't want to hurt your opponent and you come in and pow and you give them a little, like a little tap, that's okay, but that's not really the proper way to throw this kick. When I throw this kick, I turn, I chamber, snap, and come all the way back around. Again, I turn, I push my hips, snap, and come all the way back around. All right, so a few spinning hook kicks on the pad here. All right, other side. And that is spinning hook kick. Any questions? So, quick review. Anaso Pakro Pandal Chuggy. Inside outside crescent kicks. Anaso Pakro Pandal Chuggy. Pakaso Anaro Pandal Chuggy. Outside insides. Chip Pal Give Up. Stomp technique. Okay, we have the counter front kick, or the pop-up front kick, the bada up chuggy, bada tolio chuggy, counter roundhouse kicks. And then, dui hudio chuggy, spinning hook kicks. All right, any questions on any of those? Okay, here we go. Let's talk about jumping crescent kicks. Okay, so for purple belt kicks, before we get into the jumping, we don't talk about these a whole lot because these are more like sparring kicks. Before we talk about the jumping crescent kicks, just like we said for orange belts, how orange belts should practice throwing all of their basic level kicks off the lead leg. Yellow and green, learning how to throw front leg axe kicks, front leg hook kicks. For purples, purple should be able to throw their basic level, their five basic kicks, front, round, side, hook, an axe from that shuffle position. So shuffling kicks, all right? So I slide like a sliding step, back leg to front leg, front kick. Again, I'll do three each one. So shuffle, front kick. By the other side, shuffle, front kick. My back leg slides or shuffles to the front leg, almost like a sliding step. One more time, shuffle front. So for purples, this should be pretty easy. This is on the purple belt sheet. So same thing with roundhouse kick, slide, roundhouse. Again, slide, roundhouse. Slide, roundhouse. Other side, slide, roundhouse. All right, shuffle side kick, same thing. Shuffle and then side kick. I slide the back leg up to the front leg. So it's not a step and it's not a jump. Shuffle. Other side. Same thing with the hook kick from the stance. I could do it like this. This is okay. This is ideal. And I turn my hips as I move. So I'm here, shuffle hook. Other side. And the same thing with the axe. So I'm here, shuffle, one. Shuffle axe kick. Other side. Slide, one. So, purples, all of the basic kicks, now with the shuffle off that lead leg. It's like, more like a sparring kick, okay? All right, let's see if anybody has any questions. Okay, moving on. We're gonna talk about the jumping inside-outside and outside-inside crescent. These are the first two, like, new kicks for purples, not including those shuffling kicks. So, like a jumping front kick and a jumping axe kick, my lead leg is the kicking leg. My back leg is going to come up, jumping, and then inside-outside crescent, hitting across. Again. Two. Three. Four. I don't know if you can tell, I'm not slamming the foot down like an axe kick, but hitting across. Other side. Jumping inside out. So, jumping inside, outside crescent. Jumping outside, inside crescent works the same way. Front leg is the kicking leg. My back leg comes up. Other leg goes outside to in. Trying to get that large arcing motion. So, here we go. Idan. Hakuso on a row, pandal chogi. Jump. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Other side. One. Two. Arcing it across. Three. Right now I'm not hitting my hand. It's very common to hit your own hand. This way. One more. So that's jumping inside out, jumping outside in. Idan, Anaso Pakro Pandal Chuggy, Idan Pakaso Anaro Pandal Chuggy. Here we go. One more for purples. So, spinning crescent kick. When we do spinning crescent kick, we're actually talking about inside out. So I'm hitting with the outside edge of my foot. All right, I'm not going outside in like a tornado kick or the one that we just previously did, but I'm turning like a spinning back, wheel kick, hook kick, but now the foot comes up and over. So notice my posture. Whereas the back kick, I push forward here, my kick comes straight down the middle. Wheel kick, I turn, I push my hips, I drop my shoulders, my leg comes all the way around. Spinning hook kick, similar. I turn, I push my hips, I drop my shoulders, the leg snaps, and I come all the way around. With the spinning crescent, it's a closer range kick, and I stay relatively upright. I turn, my head turns, up and over. Turn, up and over. So you can see it on the other side. Turn, up and over. I turn, I pick up my knee. When I get to about the center, up and over. I have a window about that big where my leg extends and comes down. All right, so I'll throw a few on this so you guys can see. Spinning inside, outside, crescent kick. Make sure we can see in both views. That's bad. Other side. My foot comes back into my stance. Spinning inside, outside, crescent kick. Okay, that's all of the kicking techniques up through purple. Who's got questions? I know originally we were going to do weapons, spins, and strikes, but the last few weeks, we've been really driving a lot of that stuff home. So there are the recordings in great detail in regards to that stuff. So if everybody's good with continuing on the kicks, until the end of this session, I'm just gonna keep going with all of the kicks, explaining how each kick works. So thumbs up if we like that idea. Let's see. All of the kicks up to purple. So we got some blue belt kicks to do. I hope everybody's following along. I'm getting a good sweat myself. At last count, I think I'm close to 300 kicks. So if you guys have been staying with me all day, you guys are doing those as well. Let's see. We got. All right. Blue belt doesn't have, let's see, on spinning pressing kicks. I'm guessing that means crescent kicks. Autocorrect. Let's see. For some reason, my comments on the iPad are not refreshing. So let's see. Let's see what that says. Yeah, on the iPad, the comments are not refreshing. Let's see. Do you push your hips out on crescent kicks? On spinning crescent kicks? I kind of sit back So, on wheel kicks, so I don't know if you guys can see. I'll face this way. On wheel kicks and hook kicks, after I turn, I push my hips towards the kick. When I do crescent kicks, I kind of sit back on my kick. So, when I throw an inside outside, when I throw a regular inside outside crescent kick, how I kind of, and I'm really exaggerating, how I kind of sit back on my kick. Same thing with the spin. I don't know if you can see my head go like this. I kind of drop my weight to help pull that kick through. That way I can get a good like snap coming through that kick. I hope that helps. All right, so again, ever so slightly, even the regular crescent kicks, how I kind of rock my hips. And I know it looks like I'm sitting down. It's mostly because I'm going like this. Like I'm kind of like pushing my hips forward as opposed to back kicks and wheel kicks. I'm going this way. So this way on back kicks and wheel kicks, and this way on axe kicks and crescent kicks and things like that. Does that help? I hope. All right, here we go. Now we're gonna start getting into some of the tough kicks. So hopefully we don't have any questions on any of those regular kicks. Let's see, yeah. Here we go. So, when I throw a diagonal kick, it's not just a front kick that goes off on an angle, okay? But it's more like, here we go. Question? Yeah, good, thanks. All right, so, when I throw a diagonal kick, I turn my body and I dip my shoulder. My knee is going to chamber like this, and then it's going to turn outward this way. Because I want my toes to point out, not up. Because I want to hit with the ball of the foot. So I turn, dip my shoulder, my knee comes this way, and then I turn out that way. I don't know if you guys can see. I'll move over a little bit. There's the chamber. So, turn and dip. One. Diagonal kick. Two. Three. Four. Five. Try the other side. A little less flexible on this side. My turn. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. Okay? When I do the front leg diagonal kick, it's similar. Except I don't get the same kind of twist, okay? I kind of have to dip my shoulder and throw the kick. So off the lead leg, I kind of dip my shoulder, my knee comes up, and then I twist into the kick. So ready? That was two, three, four, five. Other side, front leg. So, I know in the manual, it's not listed as a separate kick, front leg diagonal. But the rule is, most kicks, if you learn how to do it off your front leg, off your back leg, you should learn how to do it off your lead leg as well. It just takes a little bit of hip maneuverability, moving it around. All right, with jumping diagonal kick, is difficult in the sense that if you pick your knee straight up, it's hard to get the twist and the proper diagonal kick without kicking your jumping leg. For example, I'm not going to do it because I'm not going to fall. I pick this up, and then as I jump and I bring that knee across, sometimes people tend to hit that. So, one thing that you can do, instead of bringing the knee straight up, you could bring the knee slightly, not like here, but you could bring the knee slightly inward. That way, you can get the twist and throw the diagonal. So, jumping, diagonal. One. Just like a jumping front, only I still get that twist. Two. It's harder to get that twist. Three. Four. Side, jumping diagonal kick, one, two, three, four, five, jumping diagonal. Okay, so, that is one of the last of our, even though diagonal kick in itself is difficult, that's one of the last of the standing regular type of kicks, unless you're getting into like the closer range, Hapkido style kicks, like the lower like shin kick, scoop kick, the inward hook kicks, and all of that stuff that we are most likely not going to get to today. Instead, we're going to start talking about jumping and spinning. So, if anybody has any questions, now is the time. Because we're going to start getting into some jumping and spinning kicks. Let's check our time. Okay. So our plan is before 7 o'clock is to get the rest of our kicks. Okay. So if you're just joining us, originally we were going to do line drills and then we were going to do weapons basics. But since we've done a lot of that lately, today we're focusing on how to do every kick. Okay, so starting at 3 o'clock today, if you go back and look at the videos from earlier, we started from front kick, we went all the way up through the belt order, front round side, stepping front round side, all of them. To the best of my knowledge, the only one we skipped was flying side kick, and for good reason, okay? All the kids like doing flying side kicks. It's never hard to get people to practice that, but getting people to practice the other kicks that need work, that's what we're doing today. So just a quick recap. We've already covered, if you're just joining us, we've covered front kick, roundhouse kick, side kick, stepping front, round side, jumping front, round side. We've done back kick. We've done spinning back kick. We've covered all of the basic kicks off the lead leg, how to throw them, front, round, side, axe, hook kick. We've done axe kick and hook kick off the back leg. We've done, I don't know if I mentioned spinning back kick. We've done wheel kick. We've done stepping axe, jumping axe, stepping hook, jumping hook. We did spinning hook kick. We did jump spinning back kick. We did inside outside crescent. Outside inside crescent, stomp kick. We've done, what am I missing? We've done jumping inside outside crescent, jumping outside inside crescent. We've done the shuffle kicks, shuffle front, shuffle round, shuffle side, shuffle hook, and shuffle axe. We've done, We've done spinning inside outside crescent. We've done diagonal kick. We've done front leg diagonal kick. We've done jumping diagonal kick. And I believe that we are all pop-up front kick and pop-up roundhouse kick. So we've covered all of that so far. So if you have any questions regarding any of those kicks, please refer earlier in this video or the 3 o'clock video. Other than that, if we're all good, thumbs up, we're going to start getting to some of the advanced kicks. We're going to try to get all the way up through the Chodunbo kicks today. Okay, so the first one that I know the children are waiting for and some of the adults, tornado kick. So when I do tornado kick, here's the thing. The spin, don't think of it as a spin. Think of it as looking at you. I turn, I pick up my knee, now I'm looking at you again, then I throw the outside inside crescent. All it is, it's a turning 360 degrees and then a jumping outside inside crescent kick. So the purple belt kick, when we do jumping outside inside, that's all it is, I'm just adding a spin. When I learn it, what's that say? Yay, I know people were waiting for this one. Okay, so when I throw this, work on first. If I'm breaking this up into stages, if I'm a student that's having a really difficult time with this, what I would suggest is work on completing the kick in two stages first. So here would be the first part of the stage. I turn. Keeping my back up straight. Now I pick my leg up. I complete my turn. I put it down in front. Outside, inside, crescent. So if I'm just learning this kick and I'm having a really difficult time, instead of trying to jump and spin all in one motion and kicking off the wrong leg or whatever, that's how we get hurt. My front leg is the kicking leg. Just remember that. Front leg is the kicking leg. I turn. I pick the other knee up. I put it in front. Outside, inside, crescent. So let's do it like that again. So again, this is the two-stage approach. Okay? Turn. Knee comes up. Put it in front. Outside, inside, crescent. What I learned from doing it that way is that I learn to not do the kick until I see you again. Does everybody understand? A lot of times when people learn this kick, they try to jump and spin right away and the kick is like over here. Like they do one of these. Like the kick's there. My target's here. So, working on getting that complete circle. And that's the same for when we do the roundhouse kick version. Okay? Turn. Leg comes up. Down. Roundhouse kick. When we get to that. Alright? So that would be stage one, is to practice it like that. Second stage would be to practice it like this. I turn. I get that knee up. I keep the knee up, and then jump outside inside crescent. Again, this is the second stage. How I would recommend you practice. Turn. Knee comes up. Complete the turn. Jump outside inside crescent. I would practice it in those two stages first. Both sides. Getting comfortable, doing it like that, making sure that your kick comes all the way to the center. Okay? Until finally, you're able to put the whole thing together, and that's when putting the hand there sometimes helps. So when I come in, if I stick this hand out, that at least gives me a visual target. If I'm not actually, aiming at a target. Okay? So, I'm going to do it this way so you guys can see. All right, here we go. Tornado kick. We're going to do it in the final stage. The whole kick. All right, turn, jump, crescent. How my kick peaks down the center. Two. Three. Four. Five. Other side. One. Notice, kicking foot comes back in front. Two. So, for me, as I was throwing those kicks, notice I was trying not to overcommit on my kicks. Trying not to get to this position here, but trying to peak the kick where it's supposed to be and still end up in front. Very common, especially if you are trying to really crush that kick, almost like a 540 coming all the way around. Okay. So, moving right along, that was tornado kick. Now we're going to talk about 360 jump spinning back kick. So many people get this one and the other one, actually people generally get confused and they mix and match this kick with other kicks. So, if I'm throwing a regular spinning back kick, my back leg is kicking, I turn, kick over my shoulder and I land in front. I ended up with my kicking foot in front. Okay? If I made that a regular jump spinning back kick, that otherwise known as the 180 back kick, it's the same exact thing, except I'm jumping. Okay? This is not that kick. So many people get confused between jump spinning back kick 180, boom, that one, and the one that we are about to do. If that kick, and I know I didn't throw it, but if that kick is the one that you have the hard time with, I would go back to the beginning of this video when we talk about jump spinning back kick. Okay? But this is the blue belt kick, 360 back kick. So, the foot that's in front, just like tornado kick and 360 roundhouse kick, the front leg is the kicking leg. If I were going to practice this one in stages, like how I do with the tornado kick, think of it like this. This is my kicking leg. Think of it like faking a front kick with the back leg, putting it down in front, turning, kicking with a spinning back kick. Again, like a stepping spinning back kick with that knee coming up high. So, if I were stepping and spinning back kick, it's the same kind of thing. But the knee comes up. So this leg is the kicking leg. Up, down, boom. That's how I should practice this in stages if I'm having a hard time with this. So again, up, down, boom. Up, down, boom. I hope you guys can see from that other angle because this kick takes up a lot of space. This should be like two full fighting stances. That's how much distance you could cover with this kick. up, down, boom. Also, side note, you notice how with every kick, when I'm done, reset. Every kick, after you're done kicking, reset. You never know, your kick was blocked, you missed, didn't kick hard enough. You want to be ready. You want to be in a decent position to defend yourself. So again, one more time, breaking this up in stages. Front leg is the kicking leg. Back leg comes up, down. Turn and look over the shoulder in a spinning back kick. So, when I'm actually throwing this, without the kick, the jumping motion is up and around. Again, if I were doing, and I know that little window is covering my legs. So, that step through version that I did towards the camera. Boom. Now, the second stage practicing would be the full jump, but without the kick. So I'm here. My back leg is going to come up because this would normally be the foot that's going to kick. Up and around. I'm in this position. I'm going to end up in the same position. After the kick, I would be here again. Because I'm turning one full 360. So again, without the kick, up and around. All right? This time with the kick. And I will keep that other little window off because I think it's just going to block how it looks. 360 back kick. Sampek Yuksukdo Yidan Bui Toryo Chucky. Kick 360 back kick. Okay. So, next one. Talking about 360 roundhouse kick. This is the tornado version of the roundhouse kick. So, just like how we broke up the other one in steps, we will do the same thing with 360 roundhouse. So, I'm here. I turn. Pick my knee up. Jumping roundhouse kick. That's the progression, how I would learn this. So, I'm basically just turning, jumping roundhouse kick. So that was two. Turn, and the difference is, with the crescent kick, I'm here. It's a closer range kick, where the roundhouse kick, I should be fully extended. The difference between the 360 round and the regular tornado kick is the range, okay? So I'm here, jump around. Side. 360 wrap. Next one, we're going to talk about spinning axe kick. So, when I throw a spinning axe kick, it's very common when people throw a spinning axe kick, they throw the kick and they pull it back behind them like a crescent. All axe kicks that we throw here chop down on the target. If I were chopping firewood, I would take my axe and I would chop down on the log in front of me. I wouldn't take my axe and swing it through my legs. So, when I throw a regular axe kick, I land in front. When I throw a back leg, stepping, jumping, land the axe kick in front because I'm what makes the axe kick what it is that chopping forward and down motion, okay? I don't want to pull the leg back because then I'm hitting more like a crescent kick, and that's different, okay? So, that's one. Two, with the spinning axe kick, if you focus too much on the inside-outside motion of the leg, it's very common to overshoot the target because you are already spinning. So, the spin itself, a lot of times, will take care of the inside-outside motion of the kick. So when I throw a spinning axe kick, I work on getting the proper spin, but then just picking the knee up and chopping down. So again, spinning axe kick, I try to keep my posture up, chopping down. Then I step back to reset. Front. Other side. So that takes care of all of the basic kicks all the way through brown belt. Brown belt and under, that is all of the kicks. Does anybody have any questions? We still have six people on with us. Anybody? Any questions on brown belt and below kicks? We do have the videos for if anybody missed anything, came late. Good. I hope everybody's throwing as many as I'm throwing. Okay. Let's start with, it's funny. On my list over here, I tried not to skip any. And as we're going through these kicks, I'm like, oh, I forgot to add this. No, I forgot to add that. So we're getting extra kicks today. Here we go. I'll move to here. Okay, we're going to talk about sitting kicks. These are the second red belt kicks, okay? We'll do a few each side. So the rule is, whatever foot is in front, I see comments appearing. Let's see. Oh, good. Thumbs ups. All right. So, the rule with the basic kicks, whatever foot is in front, that's the foot that's going to kick. So with the front kick, roundhouse kick, and side kick, the front leg is the kicking leg. Also, I don't just kick from here. That's very weak. What I want to have is a good solid base. So first, when I practice this from a proper seated position. My hands will come down at my side. That's the first part of my base. The second part of my base is that my inside leg goes flat on the ground. Because when I throw the kick, I'm not just going to throw it from here, but I'm going to push my hips up off the ground and then kick and back down. So again, hands come down, foot goes flat, push the hips up off the ground. I like kicking in front of me. Some people like kicking up here. Me personally, I'd rather hit the person in front of me than wait until they're over top of me. That's my personal opinion. If I had to hit them above me, that's one thing, but I'd rather kick them when they are in front of me instead of waiting until they're too close. Whether I'm aiming at their groin or aiming at their kneecap, I'd rather hit them when they're there. So here we go. Hands come down, foot goes down, boom. Still hitting with the ball of the foot. And then I switch legs, do the other side. Hands come flat, foot goes flat. One, two, three. And switch. Okay? Got a frame on that other camera. Here we go. Sitting roundhouse kick. Front leg is the kicking leg. I don't go like this. That's really terrible and weak. Instead, get my hips up off the ground. Hips up off the ground. I like cutting straight across with this kick. Right at the legs this way. Boom. And then back down. So again, turn my hip, get the hips up off the ground. Some people like kicking here. That's okay. For this one, I like kicking here. Right across the leg. And back down. And then back down. Other side. Hands come down. Alright. For the side kick, there are two ways of throwing this. You could throw it straight out. I'm going to demonstrate both ways. And you could do like how it appears in the forms where your foot sticks up. Okay? So, same as the roundhouse kick. I get my hands over. I get my hips up off the ground. My hips are pointing at the target. Side kick. So that's the straight out version. Hitting at the kneecap this way. Boom. And then back down. So again. And now the version where my chest goes to the ground and the kick comes up. So again, I'm using the ground as the base for my kick. So I roll over, chest is down, hitting with the heel, three chamber and coming back. Chest down, kick, three chamber and back. Other side, we'll do two mid-level. Chest down version. Seated axe kick. Hands come flat. Foot goes flat. I make sure I don't slam my heel so hard on the ground. Not like this. Okay? For safety, I do my full leg. So again. Switch. Switch. All right. Seated hook kick. Like the side kick and the roundhouse kick, I roll over, turn my hips, straight across. And then finally, sitting spinning back kick. Sitting spinning back kick, my inside leg is the kicking leg. So I roll towards that leg, I get my chest to the ground, I roll all the way over, throw the kick, re-chamber, go back the way I came. Again, flip over, kick, re-chamber, I'm back. Switch. Over this way. Okay. Any questions? Those are all the seated versions of the basic kicks. Okay. So, the majority of the remaining kicks are all the jumping and spinning kicks. Typically first up and higher. Does anybody have any questions before we start? Sitting spinning back is awesome, but I never knew it was a thing. And now we do. Every once in a while, the opportunity presents itself to throw it. I can't say that you'll never throw it. It's likely that you won't. Me personally, I've thrown it, and not like on targets. I mean like sparring, messing around. You know, I've personally thrown it myself a handful of times. Like I said, the opportunity doesn't always present itself, but if you've never done it before, then you'll never do it. But if you've done it a few times, practiced it a few times, then you know that it's there. You know, how likely will it be that you throw it? Okay, let's see how we're doing on time. Oh boy, let's see what we can get done in the next 14 minutes. Okay, so may need to raise this up a little bit, although don't know about you guys, but I'm getting a good workout. Been throwing kicks since 3 o'clock this afternoon. Certainly getting my work in. Gonna challenge myself a little bit. See if I can still hit it this high. We're gonna throw the one that I can't use this because I don't have a partner. So we're gonna first do jump spinning axe kick. Typically the order that we would learn things would not be jump spinning axe kick first, but I want to get that one out of the way. All of the first gup kicks are generally all of the jumping and spinning kicks. So whichever order you learn them in, jump spinning crescent, which is inside out, not tornado kick, jump spinning crescent, jump spinning hook, jump spinning wheel, jump spinning axe. So that's what we're going to try and get to. If we can get to those in the next 14 minutes, that would be awesome. Okay? I think I might actually throw, instead of five, I might throw three so we can get to them all. Because I would like to get you guys all of the kicks, including the double kicks, which time's going to be a little tight. So, First is the jump spinning axe. Jump spinning axe is the same as the spinning axe, exactly the same way, except I jump and I land with the foot in front. So, let's see, let's make sure I'm in a good spot. So jump spinning axe kick in my fighting stance, jumping up. Now, okay, the hard part about jump spinning axe is getting the kick to come all the way around into the center. It is difficult when you don't have an actual target to look at. I'm actually aiming at myself in the monitor. So big jump spinning axe, trying to come all the way around facing the front. Let's get one more. One more good one. Landing in front. Okay, moving on. Jump spinning crescent kick. So like a regular spinning crescent, I turn, knee comes up, I come around. Keeping my posture up, nice and straight. Hold on one second. Uniform repair. So when I throw the jump spinning crescent, it's the same idea. Making sure that I try to keep my back up straight as much as I can. Hitting with the outside edge of the foot, trying to keep the knee bent until the moment before impact. One second. All right. So here we go. Jump spinning crescent kick. This leg is going to be the kicking leg. Other side. Jump spinning crescent kick. Okay? Let's see if anybody has any questions on jump spinning crescent. Jump spinning hook and jump spinning wheel are similar. Alright. Jump spinning hook kick. I want to be a little bit further away. I turn and look over the shoulder, leg comes around in a hooking motion. So, jump spinning hook. Other side. Jump spinning wheel. Jump spinning wheel is one of the harder ones to throw. When I throw the jump spinning wheel, I try to keep my leg straight all the way through the target. So, jump spinning wheel, and I went right over. Jump spinning wheel. Thank you. Okay. Jump spinning wheel. Okay. All right. So, we still have a few minutes. If anybody has any questions regarding the previous kicks that I spoke about. Okay? Anything? All right. So, we have a few more. We have double front kick, separate time. What that basically is I'm throwing a back leg front kick and then another back leg front kick, but without my feet touching the ground. So, again, one, two, but how like a jumping front kick is. So, I'm gonna throw snap and then snap. And that's one. So two kicks, one jump. Two. Three. Four. Five. Same thing on the other side. So I'm here in my stance. One. Two. Three. Four. Five. So those are double front kick, separate time. Some call it double action. I was always taught separate time because it's okay. Next, double roundhouse kick would be same idea. One, two, but without putting the feet down, similar to a jumping roundhouse kick. So, one, two. Typically, when you throw this kick, it is difficult to fully commit to the first side in a full straight across roundhouse kick. So generally, the first roundhouse kick will come up at a slight angle, while the second roundhouse kick can be fully committed straight across. So, the reason why is, if I'm over committing here, then it's harder to come back the other way. But I don't want to throw it like a front kick, even though you could. That's a separate kick, front and then round. Once you learn the idea behind the double action kicks, you can kind of play around with changing it to front, 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 round, 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 front, axe. It's all by what you can do. So here we go. Double roundhouse kick. First one's going to be at a slight angle. So, one, two, three, four, five. Same thing, other side. One. I see a question. How do you make the front leg a front kick, not like a jumping front kick? I'm throwing it. Instead of like a jumping front kick, I bend. With a front kick, I snap. So I go snap, snap, instead of just picking it up. All right, so we're still in the round round. Here we go. So that was what, two? Three. 4. 5. Double round. Okay? Did I answer the question about the front kicks? Let's see. We have, what, 2 more kicks? Ooh, barely. For the last 3 kicks, because of time, I'm gonna throw 3. 3 each. We'll give everybody a second. So these 3 kicks, let's see. Yes? Okay, good. So these last 3 kicks are generally the 3 nemesis kicks that people have. Okay? And I made sure I saved them for last. Yep. And I made sure I saved them for last so my legs can be good and tired, so that I can really force myself to do good kicks for you guys. Okay? Okay, because I know everybody's been hanging out with me since 3 o'clock doing all these awesome kicks. Okay. Here we go. First one. So we just did double front kick, one then the other. We also did double roundhouse kick, one then the other. There are 2 other types of double front kicks, okay? There's double jump front kick, where the feet go like this, out at the sides. So I'm kicking a bad guy here on 45, and a bad guy here on 45. Not kicking somebody next to me here and here. People think that it's this, but it's not. It's this. I'm kicking a front kick here and a front kick here on 2 angles at 2 different targets, okay? Other one is double jump front kick, where both feet come straight up in front, like this. 2 feet, same time, almost like a drop kick, only we don't drop, okay? As far as practicality on these kicks, it's debatable. It takes a lot of skill to, number one, throw it, and number two, to employ it. Would I throw this in a real-life self-defense situation? Highly unlikely. Highly unlikely. Is this something that you could do messing around in sparring? Sure. Okay, doing advanced sparring, 2-on-1s. You want to attempt this kind of stuff? Yeah. Okay. At a certain point, when it comes to kicking, there's a level of kicking that can be employed from a practical standpoint, and then above that gets into athletic performance. You know, pushing yourself past that which you normally can do physically from a progressing in your abilities. As far as like throwing it in a confrontation, would I throw these next few? Oh, the next 2? Probably not. Alright, so, enough of my yap, okay? Double jump front kick, both feet same time. I'm going to jump right about here. You won't see my feet, but what I'm going to basically do is both knees are going to come up like next to me like this, okay? When you're learning this in stages, think of it like throwing 2 knee strikes. So that's all I'm going to do at first. And when I jump, I'm actually going to jump like if I'm on a trampoline and spring up like this. That's the takeoff. So you can see my feet. What I'm going to do is I'm going to take 1 step and spring up. That's all I'm going to do. 1 more time. Then, after I do that, I work on picking the knees up nice and tight. Also, my hands are going to come down in the middle like this, thrusting down like this. So again, so this is how you would learn it in stages. Hands are in the middle, knees come up like this. Trying to keep my back straight, not leaning back like this. Very common, and then people end up falling backwards like this, and if they don't do the break fall, they end up breaking their wrists, okay? Keep your weight forward, chest up, hands like this. So the actual kick, like I said, as I come into the middle, my hands will be here, my knees will be on the outsides of my arms, and I'm kicking in front of me and in front of me, okay? So I'll throw a few of these for you. Also, you notice I'm not running from way back here. When I learn these, we learn them running like this. That helps with the momentum, but it's more difficult and better to learn only doing like two steps, three steps. So here. Okay, questions on that one? That's one of those ones you just gotta practice, practice, and practice. You know, my advice for you younger guys, you know, practice this stuff early. It's extremely difficult to learn this stuff already as an adult and being able to learn how to throw it as an adult. Okay? You want to start early so that when you're 40, like me, you still want to kind of be able to do it, as opposed to waiting until you're older, getting serious about learning how to throw your techniques. Learn how to throw them early. Okay? If I can get another 10 years out of this kick, I will be thrilled. Same thing with the next one. Yes, it's fun. Yes, it's a fun kick. Even now, I don't throw it the same way I threw it when I was 19, but I can still kind of do it, and I feel pretty good about that, okay? Including the next one, okay? So, the next one, in my view, is the harder of the two kicks to throw because you want to keep your body weight forward and bring your knees up in front of you. So, If doing this stretch bothers you, this stretch, like if I can't go like this, it's going to be extremely difficult to throw this kick. Okay? If like this is as far as you could go, this kick is going to be hard for you. Okay? So I want to make sure that I keep my chest forward so I don't fall backward. It's hard to show this one in stages. I basically jump, I pick my knees up into my chest, and like if I was skiing, like doing like the ski jump, I bring my hands down at the sides like this, as both of my feet are up in front of me. Okay? So again, I run, I do that same kind of jump like I did on the last kick, and both hands come down at my sides while my knees, both of my knees come up the same time, and I kick in front of me. So I'll throw a few of these for you guys. So here we go. This is double jump front kick, same time, feet together. Questions. We have one more kick for this evening, and then we could call it a day.
Awesome.
Awesome. I love everybody's enthusiasm. That's really helpful in a time such as this to know that people are still excited about their training and are still dedicated to their training and putting whatever time in they can during this period. So I'm probably going to hit this one time and it's going to fly away if I throw a good kick. This is difficult to show when you don't have somebody holding for you. I will most likely have to reset this each time. So, I could probably put this around the base of the bag. Bear with me 1 second. Generally speaking, for the students, a word of advice would be try not to neglect safety, but making sure you should always try to take proper precautions. That being said, I have never set up this pad in this fashion before, so hopefully it's successful for you guys so that you can see how this kick is thrown, and for me, not to injure myself. So if Mrs. Salona is watching, I'm not going to get hurt. Okay? Alright, so this is low wheel sweep. I think we're actually good here. I think this is a good setup. I'm thinking that little view on the side might prevent you guys from seeing what's going on. So I'm actually going to close that window. Okay. Now, there is a okay way to throw this, and the better way to throw this. The okay way to throw this, and this is not the way that I throw it, which would be to turn, put my knee on the ground, and then come around and throw the kick, and spin on my knee. That's okay, that's not really proper. When I do kicking one steps, number 10, sometimes I throw it like that when I'm trying to throw it safe on my partner so I can control where the kick goes. If I were throwing the kick for real, I wouldn't spin on my knee. So again, the okay way, not necessarily proper way, would be to turn and put the knee on the ground and then come around and throw this kick and spin on the knee. I don't throw it that way. The way that I throw it is I turn and I get my weight, I don't know if you guys can tell, on the ball of this foot. My hands are down, my leg comes out, my foot comes all the way around. That way I can stand up. All right? So, I'm down, all the way around, spinning on the ball of the foot. Here we go. Other side, spinning on the ball of the foot. That way I can come all the way back up. It's like really lopsided. That's okay. Okay, come all the way up. All the way up. And those are our kicks for today. I'd like to thank you guys for hanging out. Get those kicks in. If you've done all of the kicks that I did today, you're well past 500 kicks. All right? So, with the kicks that I listed on the list, there were 5 kicks each leg. But there are at least 10 kicks that I forgot to add to that list that we did today. Shuffle kicks, stomp kicks, few others that were not on my list that we also did today. So thank you guys. If you were kicking with me since 3 o'clock, you're definitely feeling it today. So rest up, get some stretches. What is that? Pill song. Awesome. I'm glad you guys enjoyed. Send me some messages, questions, things that we can address in the next session. We didn't do weapons stuff today. We didn't do line drills, but we did all of these kicks that we've been kind of putting off for a little while. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Okay. Come up, Samida. Pill song.